tidbits. We are live, we are here, and we are going to talk about the latest trailer for Resident Evil Death Island, which is a new CGI film. I will be doing a reaction and breakdown to what is going on, but first and foremost, I should read the synopsis. DSO agent Leon S. Kennedy is on a mission to rescue Dr. Antonio Taylor from kidnappers when a mysterious woman thwarts his pursuit. Meanwhile, BSA agent Chris Redfield is investigating a zombie outbreak in San Francisco, where the cause of the infection cannot be identified. The only thing the victims have in common is that they all visited Alcatraz Island recently. Following that clue, Chris and his team head to the island where a new horror awaits them. Directed by Inshiro Hazumi of Assassination Classroom, from a screenplay of Makoto Fukami from Psychopaths, based on Resident Evil, the hit survival horror game that sold 130 million copies worldwide, Death Island is a new CGI animated film and the sequel to Resident Evil Vendetta. This film is coming out in 2023 of this year. I assume limited release in theaters in North America, so probably you better order your tickets when they go online, because when they are gone for good, and the movie probably will be fast-tracked to Blu-ray, DVD, digital, you name it, it should be on there. I always liked the RE CGI movies. I always think they had a profound place in trying to enhance the story. Of course, we see Leon yet again, and we see Chris yet again, the two returning vets from Resident Evil Vendetta, but also Leon has been in the CGI movies since the dawn of time. One curious thing to note is that this takes place after Resident Evil Vendetta, and the timeline loop for that movie was the year 2014. I'm wondering if this is going to take place a year later, 2 years later, before RE7, I would suppose. So they might fill in that timeline gap of 2015 or 2016. I think RE7 takes place in 2017. It's got to be before Chris's big adventure with not a hero, obviously, and of course that drastic face change, who we don't know who the fuck he is still after till this day. So we're going to react to this trailer and see what we can point out, and I will proceed from there. This is interesting because it's another prison setting, and I think that Revelations 2 also had it. It's nice to see a prison again, and I think Cole Veronica did as well, just putting that out there. This is Leon once again returning. He looks more equivalent to how he appeared in Resident Evil Infinite Darkness. They pointed out the jacket and how it has this sort of blue color, and it kind of reminds me of his apparel, this alternate costume that he acquired in Resident Evil 4 Remake, this sort of bonus costume that we see here. I don't know if Capcom is trying to put in a callback to that, or, you know, change the clothing up to be aligned with something familiar, but I would suppose this is the case. It looks vastly similar either way, and I kind of like it, to be honest. I like how the appearance changes throughout each and every singular game, although I will say Chris mostly looks the same from Vendetta, and we're going to talk about that later. So we see the Alcatraz prison is going to be the main locale. I would suppose that's going to be the midpoint, end point of the movie where all the drastic action happens. Someone pointed this out. Rebecca, her name is on the cup. If we remember correctly, she had a coffee carrier boy that was carrying around coffee for her. Now, I guess she figured out, hey, I learned how to make it my own after the last movie, because I almost got killed by zombies during this process of expecting what is going on in this, like, university. We have a shot here of a lot of dead bodies all over the place, which I assume is going to be another morgue sequence. Let's go forward to the cup. We have Chris in his luau gear, Hawaii gear, which is kind of interesting because we don't see Chris dress in a more casual format. I think the last time that we saw this was during Resident Evil 5 in the beginning when he had the safari gear that wasn't pinstriped or zebra striped. You know what I mean? Here's the cruise ship heading to the prison, and it seems like what they want us to focus on is the giant shark, obviously in the sea, who could be potentially infected. I know someone brought up the fact that maybe it is T Abyss, but that's banned on the black market. I don't think that is the case. We saw the T virus itself actually have, you know, some sort of repercussions and changes and distinctive properties to aquatic wildlife. And I think maybe this new virus, because it always could be a new virus, it could not be a previously established virus. It could be something new affecting the sea life. But yes, Neptune does exist for a reason. The Island of Despair. From what I gather here, this underwater scenario, it looks like differing types of liquors. I know the head, the mouth actually is a little bit different. The underjaw is not normal, so it seems like some sort of rampant mutation is happening there. But their bodies look like liquors that could swim. And that's what I'm getting from this whole sequence. We have a zombie here in an alleyway. I think that's the prison. It looks like an alleyway, though. And we see that the zombie outbreak happens here. I don't know what this will entail. It seems like this is more sea life being researched on, which is going to be probably a focal point of the movie. This is interesting. I can't tell who this character is on the left at the bottom of the stairwell, but if you remember correctly, during the end, the very, very tail end of Resident Evil Vendetta, we saw a character with the Gomez's. We saw Maria Gomez vow revenge on Chris and Leon after obliterating their family, the main antagonist in the movie. And I think Diego fused with Glenn Arias and they made the Arias tyrant baby, the big brain baby who got shot by the giant laser cannon that destroyed half a city block in Resident Evil Vendetta with no recourse whatsoever on behalf of the BSA and Nadia. Here is Maria Gomez. Here's what she looks like. And let's go back to the silhouettes. I wish I could zoom in a little bit more. But you can tell, look at the hairstyle, look at my mouse cursor here. You can tell, since this is a sequel to Resident Evil Vendetta, and since this hairstyle looks madly similar, they look like the same character. It's no way. It has to be Maria Gomez, and I think she's going to be the main antagonist of this movie. We can clearly tell something is going on in the water with this purple airborne mist. I'm not sure what's going on there. But yes, this is weird. This tells me that this probably is a new virus, or maybe the creature is pollinating the area. That could be possible. We see Chris and he looks exactly like he did during Resident Evil Vendetta. We see Leon on a new bike, which they will probably promote for the movie because I think he had a Ducati in the last film. So some bike manufacturer is probably going to do some cross promoting there. And it seems like this is no different with the way this is designed. They're probably going to use it in an action sequence. Let's just hope that it makes sense because it was quite ridiculous to see Leon throw a grenade in the middle of live traffic. You know, these movies don't make any sense. They're supposed to be action junkie fun, but I am hoping for more horror elements this time around. This is one of the reasons why they supposedly added Chris to Resident Evil Vendetta, to focus on the more darker horror aspects. And we see that whole bit with the zombie at the beginning of that movie, so I'm hoping the same happens here with Death Island. We see him riding on a bike. We see another underwater creature signifying what to expect from Death Island. And then we cut to the title card. Death Island. And then we see the big surprise, Jill Valentine, after 14 years of being on the shelf, after 14 years of being in quarantine, she finally returns for this movie. The main thing that I want to talk about before I close off this breakdown is there was some sort of fan confusion on Twitter and in social media questioning why Jill looks exactly like her iteration on Resident Evil 3 Remake. People said, is this a flashback? Are we going back in the past? But, you know, even though she looks the same, here's Jill from RE3, I think they just reeled Sasha's model. And it looks like some of her clothes, like she's still wearing the little necklace pendant right there. So it seems like they ripped the model out and they made some touches to it. Like I said, she has a little bit, her hair is a little bit shorter this time around. I'm assuming this is going to be after Resident Evil 5. And the reason why is because we see in this modern segment, in this tweet from Resident BioEvil, he said that it's not a great picture I got, but the others have the same shot, and you could tell it's Jill standing near Chris at the bottom left. You see Jill's hair. You see Chris in his luau gear. Obviously, it seems like this is in modern day. It's no way, because Jill's right next to him. Why would this be a flashback to Resident Evil 3 Nemesis? You see what I'm saying? Like, so that was firmly debunked after I saw this screen cap alone. This is after RE5 for sure. And they're using Sasha, the face model, yet again for Jill Valentine. I'm super excited. Another CGI movie. I was not expecting it. Some people told me in my Discord that they we're going to put probably the kibosh on the CGI stuff for a while because one of the main producers who liked Leon actually left Capcom. One of the main proponents of creating the CGI movies left Capcom. So that left the future in limbo for Death Island. I did not expect this to come out of the blue like this out of nowhere. But it's very cool that Jill is now returning, and it's going to be very interesting to see. Not only do we have Chris and Leon in the same picture, but we have the possibility of Jill meeting Leon for the first time ever. And like I said, I just have a feeling Leon's gonna try to make a pass at them cheeks. Anyway, Leon and Jill interacting is so exciting. Tell me what you guys thought of the video. Hopefully you like this breakdown. Be sure to like, share, and subscribe, and tell me your thoughts on what you expect, your anticipation, your hype level on Resident Evil Death Island. I will see you guys next time, and soon as more develops on this movie, as well as making a discussion, because we already made a discussion on what the fuck was it? I forget the name. Infinite Darkness. As soon as we make one on the podcast account, I will share it so you can see. I'm thinking of going back and talking about the original three CGI movies in a more constructive format. So look forward to that, and I will see you guys next time. Later.